Hey there everyone, this is Michael, the Nootropic Reviewer, and during this video, you're going to learn about the many side effects that come along with taking Alpha-GPC as a nootropic supplement. I'm going to take 300 milligrams right now to get in state for this video. I don't feel any side effects, but maybe you've experienced side effects. Now, I've been using it for 7 years. I love it. It's increased my income. It's helped me build businesses. I'm more focused. My memory's better. I'm able to think clearer. However, a lot of people experience very negative side effects, and some of those do include headaches. They include depressive symptoms. People experience like even withdrawals when they take them, and some people surprisingly get the opposite reaction than what they're supposed to get from Alpha-GPC. So instead of being able to like think clearer, they're getting brain fog. So just exactly why is this happening? That's what we're going to talk about in this video. What I want you to know sincerely is that if you are to try any choline source, whether it's choline bitartrate, whether it's CDP choline or Alpha-GPC, is that Alpha-GPC is by far the most effective one of them. And the mechanism of action in which Alpha-GPC works makes it such that it's more easily able to cross the blood-brain barrier, which naturally means it's going to make us more productive and more effective of what we want to do. However, the problem with Alpha-GPC is that you really need to find your sweet spot with it. I have spoken to so many people who said that it took them many, many months for them to understand just how to make the most out of the whole Alpha-GPC experience. And that was the case for me as well. When I first started taking Alpha-GPC, I was using about 150 milligrams once a day. And then I increased it up to like almost a gram a day. And then I felt awful. And then I found that my sweet spot was somewhere around 600 milligrams per day. Now, with Alpha-GPC, you need to understand this serves as a great like foundation for your nootropic stack. You'll look at a lot of different nootropic blends, whether it's Quality of Mind, which is very popular, Mind Lab Pro. They will almost in all cases have Alpha-GPC there. And the reason for that is because it is great across all different styles of work. Whether you're a student, whether you're somebody who's working in a sales job like myself, I sell residential real estate, or an entrepreneur, or even like a teacher, it just makes you perform better, perform a lot more effectively. And then given that Alpha-GPC is naturally occurring, it's not like man-made, you figure, why not take it? And so I even use it on like my days off or my vacations. I do take a bit of time off here and there just to like reset my tolerance. I don't like to take anything 365 days of the year. But once you find that good dose for you, you'll find you don't want to take it out of your stack because you just feel a whole lot sharper. And if you take a look online, there seems to as well be a lot of confusion about this on Reddit. These couple of posts regarding the dosage for Alpha-GPC indicate that you can even experience depression. I hear that some people who take 1,000 milligrams or more may experience depression. Somebody else had said that it can cause brain fog and depressive symptoms, and you can actually cause the exact opposite of what you're trying to achieve. So we are all different individuals, therefore we have to understand that Alpha-GPC may take a little bit of time, so be a bit patient with it. Don't try it for a few days and just give up on it entirely. And the way that I like to think of Alpha-GPC is if you were to imagine that Alpha-GPC is good at recharging your batteries. So you can understand that the harder you work in the day and the more kind of like mentally fatigued you feel, the more Alpha-GPC you can get away with. Like there's some days when I only take about 400 milligrams, and what that looks like is taking about 200 milligrams twice a day. But there's some days where I work a little bit longer and I want a little bit of a focus boost, and I find that taking that extra 200 milligrams of Alpha-GPC really helps me out. Of the many side effects though, you can consider it like headaches seem to be the most common, followed by that is sadness. I prefer saying sadness versus depression. And the third would be brain fog. And you'll hear about some unusual scenarios where people feel heartburn, but they aren't all that common. At the end of the day, Alpha-GPC, you're gonna have better results more commonly than you have bad results. You will even start to see Alpha-GPC being a common ingredient in a lot of pre-workout formulas, because there's research stating that it can actually help with growth hormone and power output. That has not been in my experience whatsoever. I don't see Alpha-GPC really being that great for working out or helping you like build muscle when it comes to like muscle hypertrophy or enhancing fat loss. But it's good on the side of focus, especially if you're somebody that maybe isn't that clear-minded during your workouts and you can get distracted. And if you don't respond well to Alpha-GPC, I would say the next best thing would be CDP choline. And generally when it comes to choline intake, you can consider like Alpha-GPC being the best, being the king. The second would be CDP choline, and then the third, so the worst, would be choline bitartrate. And choline, of course, got a lot of attention when people started taking the Racetams. Racetams being trending for improving memory, improving thinking, really enhancing learning. Yet with the Racetams specifically, it's known to have the best effects once you pair it with the choline source. So then comes the question of like, Michael, okay, if I'm not using the Racetams, is it still okay to use choline or Alpha-GPC? And the answer is absolutely. Alpha-GPC is a great supplement just by itself. It's not as if you need to have it along with a big nootropic stack or anything like that. I've taken Alpha-GPC by itself many times and seen the result that I was intending to have. Now, with CDP choline, you may want to lower your expectations a little bit. It's not as good as Alpha-GPC, and choline bitartrate is probably not going to be effective. I think the good thing with choline bitartrate is if you're to use it with paracetam, then you may not experience like the paracetam headaches, or you may get something from the paracetam. There is some research showing that Alpha-GPC can have some long-term negative effects. However, this is really not understood, and we're just waiting until more research starts to materialize. People often ask, is Alpha-GPC okay to take along with CDP choline? And the answer is, I think it is. With Alpha-GPC, the research shows that it can help you not only when it comes to thinking, but also physically. Whereas with CDP choline, not so much on the physical side, more when it comes to thinking. I still find Alpha-GPC better in both areas. And you can start as small as a dosage of like 100 milligrams of Alpha-GPC along with 100 milligrams of CDP choline. I have that practice for days when I'm ingesting modafinil, because when you're using modafinil, you just naturally may want to have more choline in order for you to avoid some of the bad side effects like anxiety or like irritability. And I find that helps me out a lot in ensuring that all my choline needs are met, along with drinking a whole lot of water. And of course, stress management is going to be key when it comes to nootropics, when it comes to personal development and being productive. Find what works for you, whether it's meditation practices, exercising, making sure you're sleeping right. All of it matters. Nootropics are just kind of like the icing on the cake. That's how I look at them. Now, when it comes to the actual brand or the form, it does not matter too much. I take it from Nootropics Depot. That's the form which I like currently. However, over the years, I have tried it from so many different vendors and I have not really found it to make a big difference. People often ask if they're better off taking the Alpha-GPC 50% form or the 99%. The truth is, it does not matter. Just note that most people tend to like the 50% more, because with the 99%, it gets very, very sticky. It's clumpy. It's sometimes like hard to ingest. If you get it in that powder form, like if you get one drop of water there, that's it. You may as well throw out the tub. It's that bad. And I hope you all did find this information helpful. If you did, then consider subscribing. Be sure to join us on our Discord chat, where we have a live 24/7 chat for support, for growth. It's great. And if you'd like to chat with me one-on-one, you can do so over on Patreon, or you can send me a direct message on Instagram. I thank you for your interest in nootropics, and I will look forward to seeing you all next time.